there have been some good British performances tonight, and Denise Lewis is in the bronze medal position in the heptathlon with just the 800 metres to come, and we'll be going back for that in a moment. David and Daley still here, and that was a big shock for Sonia O'Sullivan and for Ireland's hopes in that race. She was almost a gold medal banker, people thought.
Yeah, she was. I mean, she was very much the favourite. We knew that Wang Yung-sia was obviously great and got the world records, but we fully expected that Sonia would at least get a medal. But she looked drained. And as soon as the pressure went on, as soon as Conga from Kenya started putting the pressure on, then Sonia just dropped. She's there, she's in about sixth place. And she just went back and back. Anne Hare from New Zealand's leading at this point. Brunei in second place, Conga in third. And Sonia looks okay in the middle there. It takes a bit of a bash, but she doesn't look too relaxed or comfortable. But it's at the moment when Conga and Wang Yung-sia start winding the pace up, that Sonia just goes further and further behind.
She was fine in the first round the other day, wasn't she, at this event?
She looked good, yeah. I mean, you don't know how much the heat and humidity affected her.
It wouldn't be any hotter today than the other day, though, would it?
Again, it might have drained her. I mean, I'm sort of trying to think of reasons.
Quite,
but
yeah.
The most obvious reason is either that she's some sort of problem or that the heat and humidity really got to her. But Anne Hare leads at the moment, and it isn't that quick. And Sonia begins the move backwards.
You were saying that Sonia had only been in the village or in Atlanta for a few days.
Yeah, I mean, she said at her interview the other day that she was quite happy to prepare out of Atlanta and hadn't spent a great amount of time in the heat and humidity. I mean, maybe that was a factor. But she is very meticulous in her preparation and has raced sparingly this year. I say Hare still leading. Conga is coming through to take the lead in a moment. And Sonia's gone.
Yeah. Well, let's just look at how the race closed out. We saw her run off the track earlier.
And this, we had a brief glimpse of Paula Radcliffe there. I think ran a tremendous race, really attacked for the bronze medal. And in the end, just got mowed down in the last couple laps to come fifth. But Wang Yung's here is well away here. Here's Paula and Brunei from Italy battling out for third and fourth. And it was a terrific run for Paula Radcliffe in really hard circumstances. But Wang Yung-sia is tremendous. She won the world championships in 1993, disappeared for a few, and broke loads of world records, disappeared for a few years, is now not coached by the original guy, and has just destroyed this field, and Conga there in second place. And as David Coleman said in the commentary, one of the amazing things is that while the rest of them rested between the five and the heat in the final, she actually ran the heat of the 10,000. Which is quite an exceptional performance. So in 3 days, she's run a 5,000 heat, a 10,000 heat, and now the 5,000 final. And it's difficult to see how she can be beaten in the 10,000. I mean, what a challenge.
They have. It's that tea.
I think it's hard work. I think we've got to give them the benefit of the doubt, and she's an exceptional performer.
And Paula Radcliffe was unlucky there. She looked at one stage as though she might slip in for a bronze.
She looked as if she's going to get, or could get the bronze, but again, it is issues finishing, and there's no tougher athlete than Paula. She's so determined and is totally shattered at the end. But, I mean, she did everything that a North European could do. I mean, she was so positive in her attitude. It obviously is really difficult in that heat and humidity. And she gave it everything she's got, which is all you could ever ask. And I'm certain that she'll go on to do well in Commonwealth and European Games in the future, and then hopefully through to Sydney.
Now, Dave and I don't understand how high jump is done. We think it's absolutely, utterly impossible. You, of course, have done high jump in your time, but this boy, Steve Smith, did really well. And
it was a great competition. I mean, there was three of them left at the end that was actually battling out for the medal. The Polish guy looked to have sealed it at 37, mm-hmm. And Charles Austin came up with a clutch jump at the end. On his last jump, he managed 39. And you can see the three boys there. Steve Smith was always in with a shout, had to miss 37 because on the thing, what they call the count back.
Yeah.
Because even if he had made it, he would have had to make the next height, and was very close again at 39.
Got an extraordinary spring because he's not a very tall, well, not comparatively a tall guy in relation
to
the others.
No, he's only about 5'10", 5'11", whereas the Polish guy, he's 6'5 or 6'6. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, he's got a great deal of spring. And he was just a bit unlucky. I think with a bit more fortune, you know, he might have made it. But he can still be very happy because he competed very well.
Yeah.
As he said, the whole year he's actually been jumping well but never got any great heights. And today he was fabulous.
Another bronze medal in the bag.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Now, the amazing thing for me is how well Roger Black is going in the 400.
Yeah, Rog looked great today. I mean, he was very professional. He used all his experience and didn't have to run any faster than normal. Roger's here in lane four, and really all he really wants to do is make sure that he makes the final and without unduly exerting yourself, because obviously the final is the most important. He's running down the back straight. Alvin Harrison's on the outside of him, and he's caught him nice and early. And the other guy who's running well here is Clark of Jamaica. And really what Roger wants to do is to exert as little effort as possible and really just as a confidence booster and try and show the other guys that he's running very easy, because the class man is obviously going to be Michael Johnson in this race. And everything else is up for grabs, because now that Butch Reynolds doesn't look any good.
Never seen him look smoother, Daley. Just looks absolutely composed.
You know, I think he's at peace with himself. He's not injured. He's had a year's worth of training, and he's running really well. And the other guys, apart from Michael Johnson, are not up to much. Mm-hmm. And I think that he can probably run in the low 44s, maybe even a little faster.
Yeah, but he can't win the gold medal, can he? Well, it seems obvious that Johnson's going to win the gold medal.
Go on. No, it's as near certain as you could get. I mean, Michael Johnson is running phenomenally well. Yesterday, in the first round, he ran relatively slowly in the first 200 and then came through quickly. Today, he decided to go a bit quicker over the first 200.
Well, what about our man in this?
Ewan Thomas.
From nowhere.
Brilliant run, wasn't it? And fantastic run to get into the final. And he's had an exceptional season. And a lot of pressure. There's Johnson in his fancy shoes. Very upright style. And as I said, goes out relatively quickly for him over the first 200 in, you know, bearing in mind it's a heat. And then soon after this point, he really does seriously look around. And Ewan Thomas in lane three is having an exceptional, a real look to the right and the left.
He knows that there's anybody else there, I think.
If it was possible to lap the field in the 400, he'd get close to it.
Exactly.
But look at the way Ewan Thomas is fighting there, battling for that fourth position to make certain of getting into the final. And that's a great run. And Johnson, you know, Johnson's throttling back there. And he is, you know, a class above everybody else. He's, you know, potentially could get the world record. But really, as Daley said, Roger's running phenomenally well. And, you know, and really should be there or thereabouts for the silver.
And the other thing is, Ewan Thomas today, I mean, that was more or less his final. Before he came here, the most he ever could have hoped for was to get
Wembley,
to the semi.
Like
yeah, and he's really well there. And if he can make that one more leap and maybe take two or three tenths off his best again tomorrow, there's no reason why he couldn't be in the frame.
He has some great memories of these Olympics anyway now.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely fantastic. Well, as I say, we're going back for the Hep.